going on, guys? It's Steve. Now, this is something I've been saying for a very, very, very long time. But last night, dare I say, proved what I've been saying for a very long time about my main man, Carmelo Anthony, and the Oklahoma City Thunder. Now, I'm not going to sit here and lie to y'all. It's kind of breaking my heart to see Carmelo. It's kind of breaking my heart to see him average under 20 for the first time in his career. You know, that it breaks my heart. He's averaging like 18 points per game, all right? And that really hurts me because I wanted him to be with LeBron in terms of the only two players to never average under 20 points per game for 15 straight seasons. All right? I think Michael Jordan and Kareem are in there, but that's what I wanted Carmelo to be a part of. Okay, so all of this nonsense, oh, Melo's overrated, this here, yeah, whatever. But I sit here and I tell you this right now. By the way, I'm so tired of my New York Knicks losing. We lost to the Memphis Grizzlies last night. Are you serious? The Memphis Grizzlies. Mike Conley ain't even playing. Come on, man. Anyway, I'll sit here and tell you this right now. Look at this. Last night against the Los Angeles Lakers, Carmelo really didn't even have to play in the fourth quarter. None of them did because obviously they dominated the Lakers because the Lakers are butt cheeks. And I saw this stat where, like, I think it was Lonzo Ball, that without Lonzo, they haven't won a single game without him, which is ridiculous. But that's besides the point. But look at this. In 27 minutes, Melo had 27 points, 3 rebounds, 2 assists. He shot 67% from the field, 10 of 15. All right. In 27 minutes. Now listen to this. Paul George, in 30 minutes. 5 of 14 from the field, shooting 35% from the field, had 13 points, 5 rebounds, and 3 assists. Now, I'm not going to sit here and act like Carmelo's going to do this every single game, shoot 70% from the field. But I'm going to sit here and tell you this right now. If Russell Westbrook continues to find Melo like he did last night, it'll be over. Games will be over by the third quarter. I said this before, and I'll say this again. The Oklahoma City Thunder should definitely be like the Golden State Warriors. They should be smoking teams by 20, 30 points where Melo, Russ, and PG don't even have to play in the freaking fourth quarter. There should be no reason why, unless they're going up against like the Houston Rockets or, you know, the Warriors or the Cavaliers, there should be no reason why they should be playing in the fourth quarter, and even Steven Adams as well. There's no reason why any of those four players should be playing in the fourth quarter. No way in hell. You got Russell Westbrook, who's a walking triple-double. All right. In 28 minutes, he had 19.6 rebounds, 7 assists, shot 8 of 22 from the field. That's the biggest problem with this team. And I'm not going to sit here and act like Melo's the most efficient player in the world, because he's not. He averages 45% for his career, which is subpar compared to LeBron and KD, players that when Melo was in his prime would dominate. So that's not good for Melo to be shooting 45% for his career, right, from the field. But I will sit here and tell you this right now. All three of their big three are relatively inefficient compared to the Cleveland Cavaliers' best players or the Golden State Warriors' best players. Because if you, dare I say, the Golden State Warriors, Kevin Durant is 50, 40, 90. Stephen Curry is 50, 40, 90. You know what I mean? Like, damn. You know, like 50, 40, 90 for the second and third best players in the world on the same team. Being that efficient and being great on the defensive end, they're like, what are they? First in offense in the league, and they're fifth in defense in the league. Are you serious? Now, here's where the Oklahoma City Thunder are actually, you know, really good. Because it's funny because people believe, like, OKC's problems are coming from the defensive end, and that's not true at all. They're actually one of the best defensive teams in the league. I believe they're, like, second or third in defensive rating in the NBA. You know, I'm going to look this up because Steve, he knows his stuff. Let me see this real quick. All right. OKC Thunder, 2017-18, Basketball Reference. They're third in the NBA in defense right now. They're allowing teams to score 104.9 points per game. You're going to say act like defense is the problem? That's not the problem. The problem, first of all, is their bench is complete trash. That's one major issue with the Oklahoma City Thunder. But they don't even need a dominant bench. You think the Warriors' bench is really that good, or do you think their star players make the bench good? Because they have three players that can average over 20 with their eyes closed, and KD and Steph can average over 30 with their eyes closed, and Klay can average over 20 with his eyes closed. Right? And it's the same thing with the Oklahoma City Thunder. You give Russ and Melo, you know, 20, 22 shots per game, because obviously they're shooting 45% from the field, and Russ is even less than that, but you give them 20 to 25 shots per game, they're going to average nearly 30 as well. And it's the same thing with Paul George. All right, Paul George is like a Klay Thompson, in my opinion. Great defensively and pretty good offensively. He's not going to be like a Carmelo or like a Kevin Durant offensively, but he's still a solid offensive player. You know, so they're pretty much identical to the Golden State Warriors, except Melo's obviously slowed down a bit. But there should be no reason why this team should be 12th in the NBA in offense. No reason why. And it's all because of efficiency. That's the biggest problem with this team. It's just pure efficiency. All right? There's no reason why Paul George should be shooting 35% from the field. And again, I know Melo shot 67% from the field last night, but he don't do that every single game. I'm the biggest Melo fanboy in the world, but I'm not going to sit here and act like he never, you know, shoots below 40% or he never shoots below 45%. I'm not going to sit here and act like that because, come on, you know what I'm saying? But come on, man. Russell Westbrook, 36%. Like, he shot 8 of 22 last night for 19 points. You give Stephen Curry 22 shots, that's going to be like 35 to 40 points for Steph. Easily, with his eyes closed. And he's going to shoot like 50 to 60% from the field. You give 22 shots to Kevin Durant, that's going to be like 35 to 40 points as well. You know what I'm saying? So that's the biggest problem with the Oklahoma City Thunder. They're big. It's really a big four because Steven Adams is an absolute monster. The man had 21 points, 10 rebounds last night on 10 of 12 shooting. Obviously, they're all dunks and stuff like that and layups. Did you see that one pass? Yo, last night when Melo passed that, I think, how did it go? I think they were on a fast break. And No. Someone was in the corner. He passed it to Melo, and then Melo was like near the free throw line, and he passed it to Paul George. Paul George had a wide open dunk, and he did like a two-hander. Yo, I thought Paul George was about to do like a windmill or something. I was like, oh, damn. But obviously, it was just a regular two-handed dunk. Well, I was still hyped for the play because it's like, Melo don't pass the ball. Yeah, he does. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, they're starting to mesh and do well together. But in order for this team to dominate, that offensive rating has from 12th in the NBA has to go all the way to like where their defense is, third in the NBA. Because it ain't defense that's the problem. Because defensively, this team is good. It's offensively, they're struggling, okay? And by the way, Andre Robertson, you know, you're a good defensive player, but, dude, there's no reason why you're a shooting guard in the NBA and you can't shoot a free throw, man. There's no reason why you should be airballing two free throws in a row. You know, get rid of this bum, please, Sam Presti. Someone, Billy Donovan, someone, just get rid of this bum, please. All right, there's no reason he's been in the league for too long now to be airballing free throws as a shooting guard. Do you believe that? This dude is a freaking shooting guard airballing free throws. You know, and then they have a whole bunch of bums. Patrick Patterson. Raymond Felton. Had to go through with him with the Knicks. I had to deal with him with the Knicks. It's not Jerry Grant. Jerry Grant's on the Chicago Bulls now. I don't know, some kind of Grant dude. You know, it's like, their core players are good. And it's the same thing with the Warriors. Like, the Thunder should be making their bench better. And they're not. You know, because they're big three. We're really big four. But their most dominant scorers, they're just so inefficient. You know, there's no reason why all three of these players should be shooting 45% from the field or less. There's no reason for that. You know what I'm going to do? So, I want to see something real quick. I'm going to go on my laptop. I want to see what their percentages are. Here we go. Melo is, this is disgusting. Melo is shooting 42% from the field. Russ is shooting 43%. And Paul George is shooting 43%. There's no reason why. No reason why that their big three should be shooting 42.5% from the field as a combined average. It's absolutely disgusting. I want to see the Warriors for 2017-18. Oh, shoot. I'm sorry, my freaking phone is... I swear Apple makes his phone slow on purpose. All right, look at this. 2017-18 Golden State Warriors. I want to see... Because there's no reason they should be shooting that bad from the field. That's disgusting. From their big three. Steven Adams is good at 64%, but, you know, their main scorers, you know, that's ridiculous. Here we go. Kevin Durant shooting 51% from the field. Klay Thompson is shooting 49% from the field. Stephen Curry shooting 50% from the field. Draymond is shooting 45% from the field. You see the big difference. That is going to be the deciding factor in a game. That's the difference between making 1-4 shots or 2-4 shots. It's a big difference. Okay? And with the Warriors, it ain't layups and dunks. It's threes and alleys from half court and half court jump shots. You know, so something has to change with this team, but they're dominating right now. I'll tell you that right now, man. I said my. Yeah, wherever Melo goes, I gotta go. People just, you gotta understand that. But 25-20, fifth in the NBA, in the Western Conference. And I'll sit here and tell you this right now. Soon, very, very soon, they're gonna bump up to like the second, third seed. And it's going to go down in the freaking playoffs. It's gonna be OKC versus Golden State. It's been your man Steve. By the way. Yeah, it's me, man, Steve. I'm out. Peace.